Hello class, this is my student critique, and I visited The Broad in downtown LA. The two artists that stuck out to me were Andy Warhol and Jeff Koons, where I saw two great pieces of work of art that I will speak of in this presentation. This is Andy Warhol. He was an American visual artist, film director, and producer who is leading figures in visual arts movement known as pop art. Andrew Warhol was born on August 6, 1928 in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. He later on died on February 22, 1987 in New York. His periods of time were pop art and modern art. His full name was actually Andrew Warhol, but Andy for short. Jeff is another American artist, and he goes by Jeff Koons, or Jeffrey as his legal name. He's an American artist who did contemporary art. He was born on January 21st, 1955. He is currently 67 years old and was born in York, Pennsylvania. I had the opportunity to visit the Broad in downtown LA. This is a very high museum attraction and has some of the most high quality art pieces and sculptures there is. They also carry a various amount of artists in the museum. Once you walk in, you're greeted by sculptures of an old school film camera. Once you arrive to the third floor, you'll be introduced to many more pieces of art and sculptures to begin the tour. One display that caught my attention was one by Andy Warhol. It was a silkscreen. The name of the work went by Most Wanted Man Number 6, Thomas Francis. This was published in 1964. In the description of the artwork, it stated Warhol enlarged 13 mugshots for the New York Police Department. Lists of the most wanted criminals assembled into a grid. The man in the mugshot's name is Thomas Francis. I think Warhol's idea to enlarge these mugshots was a brilliant idea, and the fact that he did it for a total of 10 men is what made it even better. We're able to see things like this, such as criminals being glorified in Netflix documentaries, where they are shining the light on criminals for purpose of history. I believe the same thing can be done with this artwork done by Andy Warhol. In an article written by WarholStar.org, it states, Andy Warhol's mural, 13 Most Wanted Men, is often incorrectly referred to as 10 Most Wanted Men. The 20 feet by 20 feet mural consists of large-scale portraits of wanted criminals. It was meant to grace the New York City Pavilion, New York State Pavilion at the World's Fair in 1964, but was covered up with silver paint by the time the fair opened. Individual portraits of the mural were later displayed and sold separately. The pavilion itself has designed by Philip Johnson and Richard Foster, both who were architects. This was a very interesting thing to do because when I saw the artwork in person and saw the title, I was expecting to see 13. But after seeing the history behind it, it adds up and makes more sense to me. In another article written by the New York Times, it speaks on a man on the mugshot and what he did to end up on the mugshot. Mr. Lawyer Father, Thomas Francis, was one of Warlock's subjects in the installation. 13 Most Wanted Men was briefly displayed at the 1964 New York's Fair. He was stopped for robbing at gunpoint in Chase Manhattan Bank branch in Woodside, Queens in 1955 and making off with $300,000. The amount of money surprised me, but the incident led to him being part of Anthony's artwork and a piece of history forever. Another piece of artwork that surprised me was a piece of art done by Jeff Koons called The Couple. And in the painting done on an oil canvas, Jeff Koons is an American artist who is well known for his balloon dog sculpture. Koons was born in York, Pennsylvania. Since the age of 9, Koons was an artist, and his father knew it as well. And Wikipedia states when he was 9 years old, his father would place old master paintings that Koons copied and signed in the windows of his shop in an attempt to attract visitors. This shows the high level skill that he had at even such a young age. My mom barely even put my pictures on the refrigerator. One piece that is placed in the museum from Jeff Koons was caught my eye was his artwork called Couple. The artwork felt very abstract, but if one just takes a quick look at the piece, someone might not know what they're supposed to be looking at. And I think that is the true beauty of the work, because it seems that there is lines that split the painting on the left side and on the right side. On the left side, it seems very joyful and colorful with pretzels and more unhealthy foods. Then on the right side, you can see the color tones with less joy and the type of food such as soup, more of a sad, cooler tones. I believe that this work of art is very culturally significant because I think the painting really allows one to see two sides of things. Especially in today's world, we can all go through difficult times. And looking at this work of art, it can remind someone that there's two sides to things and can always get better. This is what I was looking forward to in the painting. In the article, it wrote the meaning of the artwork and it stated, beneath their seemingly innocent and abstract cartoon surfaces, the paintings are psychologically charged with the aspects of needs, desire, and sexuality, showing that even some of his art may seem abstract, but it has a way deeper meaning than we believe. Art can be seen by many people because some might not understand it. And art is more than just painting on canvas, but can be a way for an artist to express their emotions and how they feel at the time of their creation. Just like music, artists can make songs and you can hear what the song is about due to the lyrics. Art is the same thing, but we just must dive deeper into the work and discuss with the elements of line work, color, and lighting. The expression, a picture is worth a thousand words, is more than an expression. It can really be seen through someone's work. And being able to tell a whole story just by looking at a piece of art, this is the great thing about art. Almost a whole nother language, just from being able to dissect the meaning and be able to understand the emotions an artist is trying to share with no words needed.